Okay, so the first theme of Big Bash is violence. We can see throughout the poem, violence is there. So I have here written multiracial, multicultural, multi-religious country being globally discredited for violent communal calamity shattered in 1983. I think you can understand this. Now, our country has been considered as a multiracial country. There are different races living in our country, like Sinhalese, Muslims, Tamils, all the races are there. And multicultural, as there are several races in our country, we also find different cultures. We find the Sinhala culture, the Buddhist, Sinhala Buddhist culture, and the Muslim culture, and the Tamil Hindu culture, all these. And multi-religious country. It is also multi-religious, and everybody in our country is having the freedom to observe whatever the religion they like. So nobody is like hindering their own space. Everybody has their own attitudes and their own religious beliefs. And even, you know, some of the places like the Adams Peak, Sri Pada, all the communities, all the religions, people from all the religions are worshipping them. So they believe they have their own beliefs there. So Sri Lanka is a country like that. Sri Lanka is credited for its multiracial, multicultural, and multi-religious methods. That means the peace. Sri Lanka had peace there, having so many religions and cultures living in the same space together. But with the incidents happened in 1983, the Sri Lanka's credit of this peacefulness have been reduced. Communal calamity shattered. So communal calamity means the peace among the community. Communal calamity, the peace among the community in the country. So it was shattered. It was vanished and it was collapsed due to 1983 riots. So I have mentioned several quotations there. Right. So you can write this themes, write themes and write the first theme, violence. And you also have to tell me some points. Now I have mentioned here the quotations. Now after writing, you should tell me some of the points that you can add to describe the theme violence. You can tell anything that you feel. First you can write. Okay, so you can write this line also. The poet highlights both physical and mental suffering of the innocent civilians as a consequence of violence. Both mentally and physically, the human beings, the innocent civilians were suffering. Right. So the next theme, that is anybody writing the line? Do you need more time to write it? If you need some more time, you can tell me. Have you all finished writing? Yenuli? The earlier one? Okay, right. I'll go for the next one. Narrow selfish attitudes of politicians. The poet vehemently criticizes the politics in the country since independence. 1948, power-thirsty politicians cultivated hatred and suspicion instead of peace and harmony, misleading the innocent people. Finally, innocent helpless majority suffered from huge damage. So what happened is this was all happened due to the narrow selfish attitudes of politicians. They had some their own attitudes to promote violence, and because of their narrow selfish minded politicians, because of these narrow minded selfish minded politicians, it was the innocent people that had to suffer. So vehemently criticizes means greatly criticizes the politics in the country since independence. And 1948, power thirsty politicians have cultivated hatred and suspicion instead of peace and harmony. So though it was telling that in 1948 Sri Lanka got independence, still the politicians were not given independence to the innocent people. They always wanted to capture them by doing various things. And finally what happened was this conflict arise. Okay, please write this one as well. Right, we'll go for the third one. That was the need for peaceful coexistence. That was clearly shown in the poem, because when there were utter sufferings and disappointments, both mental and suffering were there to the people, to the innocent people, and they were suffering a lot, they were in pain. So that clearly shows, like you can see in the last stanza, how the people are suffering from the north corner of the country to the south corner of the country, how they were killed on the roads, and they even don't have any solace from the religion. They're suffering a lot. So here I have written, the poet clearly brings out the sufferings of people, innocent civilians, due to terrible violence. Through that, the poet indirectly brings out the need for naturalism and true freedom. Need for naturalism means there should be natural order in the country, not the artificial things and attitudes created by those authorities. There should be natural order of living. Everybody should be given equal rights, equal privileges. And then there'll be no conflict like that. So need for the peaceful coexistence is highly emphasized by the poet with the last line of the poem, that is, Sri Lanka burns alive. So Sri Lanka is burning alive. Now see the situation of someone burning alive. Can we even imagine burning alive? That is really critical. So the poet here, with the last line especially, the poet highlights the critical situation in the country and implies that there's a need for peaceful coexistence. People should be peacefully living there. Yes, you can write that one also with the quotations. Okay, so need for a peaceful coexistence. And the next one, a realization of social reality in the country. Realization of social reality in the country. That is something important. Due to the flaming ethnic fire, human relationships are deteriorated. People have been harassed both physically and mentally. So the thing here is now earlier, before this, now I told you Sri Lanka was a multi-religious, multi-national, multi-racial country. So all the races were living together peacefully before this ethnic riots. And they had very close relationships as well. They were neighbors and they looked into each other's affairs and they were helpful towards each other and everyone was good in that relationship, human relationship. They had a good bond. That's why now you can see the speaker here also tells that some lines have not been cut yet. So it was really a physical, mental harassment to avoid these relationships, those bonds, those human bonds. So usually we all know that we all have relationships with our parents and with our loved ones, relations and all these people, because we need some mental relaxation. And it gives those relationships, give us mental happiness to our lives. So every relationship, every strong relationship give us some kind of a good happiness, pleasure to our lives. So these were having the neighborhood relationships and the friendly relationship that they have with other races and religions, they were very pleasant for a human being. So that was lost. Those human, the social reality have been actually deteriorated. It was decreased and collapsed because although they wanted to have this relationship forever, because they know that the next door neighbor, now the Sinhala family living this home and the next door neighbor is Tamil. And they were not having grudges earlier. They were living peacefully. But due to this ethnic violence taking place in the country, it really hurt them. They are not allowed to have this nice relationship with each other. Right, so like that. So here I have mentioned the quotations, the joys of childhood, her agony, that I have only mentioned two words there, but you have to go through the whole line, the joys of childhood, friendship of our youth, ravaged by pieties and politics. So see, that was the politics who has, that was the politics and politicians who created this collapse. And no social freedom, people were brutalized merely due to the ethnic identity. As they were Tamils, they didn't have any reason to be killed because as they were Tamils, Sinhala people killed them. And as they were Sinhala, Tamil people killed them. There were no other reason. They didn't search whether these people have done something wrong to the other race. They never searched for that. But for being, for having this ethnic identity, each other were killed. So that was really a pathetic situation. Okay, by mentioning the different places of the country, Jaffna, Peta, Duplication Road, the poet tries to state that the whole society all over the country has been infected by violence. Uncontrolled mobs that suggest that these unconscious, they don't have a, like they were led by these uncontrolled mobs. Those people were led by the politicians. So they were uncontrollable. They didn't have sense what they are doing. they were only following the rule, the guidelines given by the politician. So it was so the poetess Yasmin Gulrakhna is focusing on the politicians that she's highly emphasizing that it was the politicians who has done this, who has created this violence in the country. Okay, you can quickly write this one as well.